Welcome back to ULearn Tutorial. By far, the Pen 2 is the most accurate for making selections. If you need to make selections that require straight lines and curves, then the Pen 2 is the one to use. Hi, my name is Micah Chow, and today I'm going to show you how to use the Pen 2 in Illustrator. In your preferences, your Pen 2 will either look like the tip of a pen icon or a precise icon X. When you're using the Pen tool, it's important to pay attention to make sure you're doing what you want. The image that is shown here shows exactly what type of pens are you using, either the standard or precise. I like to draw with a stroke color and no fill color. Why? If you draw or trace with a fill color, you won't be able to see what you're doing. Click on the fill color and click on none. When you use the pen tool, you're creating a path. The path consists of curve and straight segments connected by anchor points. When you click with the pen tool, you create corner points and straight segments. When you drag with the pen tool, you can create smooth points and curved segments, which have direction handles you can use to change the curved segment. The shape of the curved segment is defined by the length and direction of the direction handles. The pen tool works by placing anchor points down and drawing lines in between them. Click on the artboard when the pen tool is selected. You'll notice a point appears. Now click on another place on the artboard. Another point appears and a line is drawn between the two points. When you click and drag in one motion, the point you place will be a curve point, one which changes the nature of the path from straight to curve. The lines you see extended from a curve point as you drag are called handles. Use your hollow arrow tool, the white direct selection tool, and pull the handles or to move the point along the path. As you continue to draw, your path takes shape. One good hint, you do not need a jillion points to create a path. One to define a corner, one to define a curve. If you try to define a curve with two or three or more points, your line will be lumpy and bumpy and not great. Once you have completed your shape, you can select anchor points with the hollow arrow tool, which is the direct selection tool, to adjust them. Drawing lines. Select the pen tool. Click once to add the first anchor point. Move your mouse to the next position and click again to create the second point. The two anchor points will be connected together. Continue doing this to create a W shape as shown. If you want to draw a separate line, click the selection tool and click back the pen tool again. If you want to stop drawing with the pen tool, either hold the Control or Command key and click anywhere on the page, or choose a tool in the toolbox. I prefer the Control Command key. Continue where you left off. Choose the pen tool again or P on your keyboard to select the pen tool. Go to either end of your path and it should have a pen with a slash. If you see this, go ahead and click anywhere on the ends and continue with your drawing. To close a path, click back the starting point to close the shape. As you near the starting point, the icon will change from a plus to a circle. Draw a curve line. Select the pen tool again. Make your first point. Now make your second point, but don't release the mouse. Instead, drag the mouse downward or upward slowly. You'll notice the line starts to curve. When you get the curve you want, release the mouse button. Click and drag out the handles to create a smooth anchor point. Changing path directions. Choose the direct selection tool, the white tool. To change the path direction of an already drawn line, hold down the Option or Alt key and drag the handle up to change the path direction. Release the mouse button when ready. Drawing a circular path. Continue adding points, click and drag to create a smooth anchor point. Continue doing this to create the shape as shown. Now, click back the starting point to close the path. To change the path direction of an already drawn line, hold down the Option Alt key and drag the handle up to change the path direction. Release the mouse button when ready. Removing removes existing points from a path. To remove a point, choose a pen tool with the minus sign. Or, when the pen tool is still selected, hover over an anchor point and the pen tool will appear with the minus sign. Click on the anchor point to delete it. Adding adds additional points anywhere on a path. To add a new anchor point, choose the pen tool with the plus sign. Or, when the pen tool is still selected, hover over a path and the pen tool will appear with the plus sign. Click on the path to create a new anchor point. Converting creates a bezier handles on a point to form a curve. To convert a smooth anchor point to a sharp anchor point, a corner, move your pen tool near the anchor and hold the Option Alt key. and your pen tool will change to an arrow shape. Click on the smooth anchor to convert it to an anchor point. Click and drag on the anchor point again to change it back to a smooth anchor point. Move anchor points. Select the direct selection tool, which is the white arrow tool. To change the path direction of an already drawn line, hold the Option Alt key and drag the handle up to change the path direction. Release the mouse button when ready. Change your anchor directions. With the pen tool, you can quickly change the anchor directions. Hold Command Control key to quickly change the pen tool to direct selection tool, the white arrow tool. Select the anchor point you want to edit. The anchor handle will appear. Now, release the Command Control key and hold Option Alt to change it to convert anchor tool. Click and drag the handles to change the direction. Release the mouse button when ready. Here are some tips for using the pen tool. Use as little anchor points you need to create your shape. Add anchor points where there is a change in the direction of the line or curve. Use shortcuts like Option Alt or Command Control to quickly swap to other tools to edit your path. Hold the Shift key to lock your path while adding new anchor points for 45 degree increments. And use the direct selection tool, which is the white tool, used to select individual points or bezier handles.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please like it or share it. And also tell people about it.